In this video on subtracting mixed numbers, both the comparison and takeaway concepts of subtraction will be illustrated. We will show regrouping, which is a common technique sometimes used for subtracting mixed numbers. However, we will also show a method that avoids regrouping, but which is rarely taught when subtracting mixed numbers. The first word problem involves mixed numbers and the takeaway concept. 4 3/5 cups of grape juice are available. A recipe for grape jelly calls for 2 4/5 cups. So here we have 4 whole bars representing 4 full cups of grape juice and 3/5 of a cup. Now if this recipe is used, how much juice will be left? So let's write down what we have here. We've got 4 3/5. The cook is going to use 2 4/5, so that much is going to be taken away. We look at the 4 3/5 and we find that we see we only have 3/5 here, so we're going to replace one of these whole bars here by 5/5. Now replacing a whole bar by 5/5, or replacing one by 5/5, is called regrouping. Now we have enough fifths, we have 3 whole bars, and we have 5 3/8, we have 8/5, and we still want to take away 2 4/5. So now we can take away 2, and we can get out a water-based pen here and take away 4/5. We'll take away 1 2 3 4/5, and we're left with 1 whole bar and 4/5, 1 4/5. Let's revisit this situation with the grape juice once more. We have 4 full cups of grape juice and 3/5 of a cup. So we have 4 3/5. And as before, we want to remove 2 4/5. So we're going to begin by removing 2 whole bars. Okay, we can kind of indicate that here by crossing off the 2. And now we want to take away 4/5, and we only have 3/5 here. So we're going to go to another whole bar here, and we'll just replace this whole bar. We'll take away 4/5 from that and leave 1/5. So that's like 4/5. The complement of 4/5 is 1/5. So we've taken 4/5 away from a whole. That leaves us with 1/5. And so now we've taken away 4/5. And so we're left with 1 whole bar and 4/5. 1 4/5. So this is a method that doesn't use regrouping. And we've taken away 2 4/5 and 4 3/5, and we're left with 1 4/5 cups. Now we just computed this difference without regrouping. Let's see what this process might look like if we used pencil and paper without the bars. So we'll start with 4 3/5 minus 2 4/5. And first we'll take away the 2 here, and that's going to reduce this. We're going to take 2 away from 4, so we're going to have 2 3/5 minus 4/5. Now we usually say we can't take 4/5 3/5, but of course we could with negative numbers, but we're going to avoid negative numbers. We're just going to go over and take 4/5 away from 2. That's going to give us 1 1/5. And of course we've got the 3/5 left. And so this is going to be 1 4/5. So there's what an algorithm might look like with a pencil and paper. Did you notice the use of complement when we subtracted 4/5 from 2? Since a complement of 4/5 is 1/5, 2 4/5 is 1 1/5. Let's look at a mixed number word problem with fractions having different denominators. One LCD screen has a length of 4 1/3 feet, represented by 4 whole bars and 1/3, and a second LCD screen has a length of 2 3/4 feet, represented by 2 whole bars and 3/4. And what is the difference in the lengths of these screens? So we have 4 1/3 minus 2 3/4. And rather than takeaway, we'll use comparison to illustrate this difference. Now right away we notice we have 1/3 here and 3/4 here. So these bars have different size parts. Their fractions have different denominators. So we're going to replace 1/3 by 4/12. Common denominator here being 3 times 4. And we're going to replace 3/4 by 9/12. So we can write this then as 4 and 4/12 minus 2 and 9/12. The next thing we notice is that 9/12 is greater than 4/12. So we're going to regroup. We'll replace one of these whole bars here by 12/12. So now we have 12 and 4, we have 16/12. So this becomes 4. This becomes 3. With 3 whole bars, comes 3 and 16/12 minus 2 and 9/12. Comparing these amounts, we have 3 holes and 2 holes. 3 minus 2 is 1. And then comparing these, we have 9/12, and over here we have 16/12. So that difference is going to be 7/12. So the difference in these two, the lengths of these two LCD screens is 1 7/12 feet. Let's compute the difference in the lengths of the two LCD screens once more, and this time we'll avoid regrouping. So the longer screen has a length of 4 1/3 feet, and the shorter screen has a length of 2 3/4 feet. We can begin by taking the two away here, so we'll just take 2 whole bars away. And now, taking that away, we'll take 3/4 from one of these whole bars. So let's just replace that whole bar. If we take 3/4 away, we're going to get the complement of 3/4, which is 1/4. So this problem has been reduced now to, this difference is going to be 1 and we've got 1/4 and we've got 1/3. Now since these have different denominators, we'll replace 1/4 by 3/12, 12 being the common denominator. 1/3 we replace by 4/12. And now we can see we have 1 3/4, 1 7/12. So the difference between the two screens is 1 7/12. So regrouping can be avoided, but we did need to get common denominators. Consider these results from the National Assessment of Educational Progress test on finding the difference between mixed numbers. The first difference, 3.5 minus 3 1/3, we see that 7th graders, 53% of the 7th graders were able to do this, find this difference, and 71% of the 11th graders. Now the numbers in square brackets is the number of students responding, or the percentage of students responding. So for 7th grade it was 62%, and for the 11th graders about 1/4 of the students didn't even try to find this difference. Now in the second difference, 7 1/6 minus 3.5, 32% of the 7th graders were able to get the correct answer. And this is surprising, less than half of the 11th graders could compute this difference. In these three videos on subtraction, we have looked at word problems involving two different types of applications: comparing amounts and taking one amount away from another. These two uses of subtraction also occur when solving problems involving whole numbers. Takeaway is a popular method of illustrating subtraction in the early grades. In fact, the word subtract means to take away from under. However, it is important that students see examples of both comparison and takeaway when solving word problems, whether with whole numbers or with fractions.